All right, guys, welcome back to the Independent Investor Channel. Really, it's great to be with you guys. My name is Ryan. If you guys are looking for the best portfolio tracker out there on the market, I've got it. Stock Rover is the answer to everything that you could ever want in a one-stop shop portfolio tracker stock research tool. You don't need to look any further. If you guys are trying to and becoming frustrated with Excel spreadsheets and the maintenance that exists therein, you guys need to look at Stock Rover. It provides the opportunity for a 14-day trial. Links are provided in the description below. I'm going to provide you guys a quick walkthrough on a few of the functions and features within Stock Rover. This is a product that I use myself. We are affiliated with Stock Rover. Any links that you click on will help support the channel. I'll receive a small compensation for providing content like this. But I find myself coming back to Stock Rover as kind of a daily use tool in my stock investing and my research application. And I think for the different levels of membership that Stock Rover offers, I think there's a product that can align with your needs specifically. So you want to make sure and kick over, watch those tutorials that are provided on the Stock Rover website, that of which I'll include in the description of these videos as well. But sit back and enjoy how it is that I've been able to capture multiple accounts, bring them all into a one-stop shop like Stock Rover, and extrapolate some of the data and analytics that are provided through this awesome, awesome platform, guys. We'll jump you into the account now and conduct the review. So I think one of the coolest opportunities through social media is to be brought to products that you wouldn't have known about before, unless identified on some independent research. I've had the unique pleasure of getting familiar with Stock Rover, which is bottom line, hands down, the best portfolio tracker on the market. It blows everything else out of the water, guys. If you are trying to manage an Excel spreadsheet to provide yourself good analytics and data, you're really missing the boat here. You really are. Stock Rover allows you a 14-day trial to kind of pilot the program. They have a lot of different avenues and packages that can satisfy each and every client out there's needs. What you're looking at here is the aesthetic dashboard for the Premium Plus package that they've got, which is their elite service, which is absolutely fantastic. This is like driving a Ferrari, guys. There's no doubt about it. You can ask Stock Rover to do anything under the sun and then some. So I've chronicled the initial rollout of Stock Rover, and I know there's a lot of people out there that are looking for a tool like this. And for the main reason of time savings, it's worth taking a look at Stock Rover. Again, back to the Excel spreadsheets, it's only as good as the time spent in the data input, okay? Stock Rover does all that for you. All you have to do is take your data, throw it into Stock Rover, and it extrapolates all the metrics that you would ever need, forecasted future revenue, etc. Stock, individual stock performance, dividend renderings from quarter to yearly into the future. The sky is the limit with Stock Rover. And for you guys that may have just one portfolio with a passive ETF in it, Stock Rover might not be the best for you, okay? Now, there are tools that are available on the research side of the house, some a la carte products that you can find, some proprietary research tools, and it's fantastic. It'll print you out an eight-page document, and that is an a la carte service. But for a more advanced comprehensive portfolio like myself here, I want to earmark what this is right here on the top end of the screen. Now, I'm at the dashboard here. The dashboard is just a quick shot. This is super, super important. These are all my accounts. Okay, so basically what I did is I used the Brokerage Connect tool here to capture all of my M1 Finance accounts, all of my Merrill Edge investing accounts, as well as my Thrift Savings Plan. Now, the Thrift Savings Plan is a little more fickle. It gets caught up somewhat in the cookies, and I have to do this on a non-private tab browser to get this to update, which is totally fine. I don't mind doing that because The thrift savings plan is a tough account to link over. In other words, it's always a manual amendment or a refresh and a re-log in to get that data to stick. But Stock Rover does the best job of actually allowing that to happen, as long as you do it in an open source browser tab, which is totally fine here. But this is great, man. It gives a snapshot of the portfolios combined. Just on a quick look, if I logged into Stock Rover, it's going to give me, of course, all my market news. The charting and graphing are second to none on Stock Rover. They're incredible. There's no way on a tutorial that I'm going to get to everything. These are my holdings, one day performance. I can kick in here and do, you know, 1 year performance. I can do 5 year performance. I can do custom time framing on this. And then scrolling down here, this is on a snapshot, my projected dividend income. Guys, this is all stuff that manually has to be built into a spreadsheet or have somebody build it for you. And then you get to hope that either, number one, you don't sell a stock ever and that spreadsheet remains static. Number two is that spreadsheet, where it's pulling data from, doesn't incur some sort of an error or corruption message. That will require you to go in there and fix the master spreadsheet and or fix each individual spreadsheet. It's really just futile, and people are spending way too much time. Time is way too valuable to be spending babysitting and massaging your Excel spreadsheet all the time just to provide you rudimentary data that Stock Rover can provide on an advanced level. But this projected income here, this goes up through 2021. This is kind of cool, and then it gives the year-end recap. This is proposed dividends for my portfolio combined, 72.84, and then you can see how the dividends increased based on the current holdings projections of 8,062 total over the next couple years of 15,347 renderings, and then here's your snapshot. No need for dividend tracking here. That gives it to you. So if I look through here on a quick whim, I can go boom, starting here on Tuesday, which is tomorrow, the day after filming this video. I know I've got CVS, which is a holding of mine, reporting. I've got a double whammy on Thursday, Walmart and Royal Bank of Canada. I own them both. The following week is a big week for the Independent Investor Channel. We've got Home Depot and Medtronic. I own them both. Lowe's, I own. Salesforce, TD Dominion, I own. So some big earnings weeks coming up, and on a snapshot, you can really kick in here and be provided a daily briefing on what sectors are outperforming. I mean, how many people knew that energy is outperforming right now? 5.2%. There's technology, which is everybody's favorite, at 2.7, right? Some of the watch list and some of the stuff that I'm working. But I want to kick over here to the portfolio analytics the rebalancing. This is the real key here. This is a lot of fun. And this right here gives me the visual picture of what I really enjoy through Stock Rover. It doesn't get any simpler than this. And I've seen some Excel spreadsheets out there, guys, that are fantastic. They're beautiful. And I give kudos to the person who built them. The problem is the scalability of those products. And they are deficient in meeting the masses' needs. This is very, very simple. It tells you everything you need to know. If I click over here, this is very, very clean. The aesthetics are super, super easy to work with. And if I were going to click in here, boom, there it is in its totality. Now, keep in mind here, look at how simple this is. And look at the amount of data that is being captured here in this particular stock aspect of the portfolio. Here's all the sectors to the right in the listing. And here's how it breaks down. Now, since my portfolio is rather large and it's extensive in that it captures multiple different accounts, multiple different holdings, Stock Rover displays that in this pie overlay in a one-stop shop. Very, very cool. So, for example, we'll kick in here to consumer cyclicals for a second. That's a fairly bad example because I got a big chunk of Hylion. It looks like Pac-Man in here. But if we go back here and pick a sector, let's pick technology, everybody's favorite, right? This really tells the picture. And this is that one sector, guys. This is insane. Look at that. Boom, on a snapshot. Give you the ticker symbol, the name of the company, the percent of portfolio weighting, and the actual dollars that are rendered there. Apple, 1.5% of my total overall portfolio. Now, these small slices here, guys, this is M1 Finance. This is the brand new dividend growth portfolio that I just recently rolled out to you guys. There's Texas Instrument on a very, very small $223 position, but that just shows you how powerful stock Rover is. I didn't have to manually add this into this spreadsheet. Stock Rover does all the work for me, okay? It's direct connected to M1 Finance, so therefore any changes to M1 Finance, any changes to Merrill Edge will be reflected within the one-stop shop Stock Rover platform. Boom, there's the little piece of intel that I've got. Let's kick over here. There's the small piece of Broadcom that I have, the small piece of AMD that I have. And then these represent the larger pieces, right? Salesforce.com, there's CrowdStrike, there's Cisco Systems, and around the horn, right? And just for sake of showing you guys and really showcasing the power of this, let's kick into basic materials. Kind of cool, right? APD here, we've got BHP Billiton, we've got Lindy, and we've got Sherwin-Williams here that just incurred a stock split. And we'll show you one more just for the sake of demonstration purposes. Shoot, let's kick into communication services. So this, guys, gives you the visual. This right here is what I see attempted to be duplicated across the Excel spreadsheet landscape. And they're failing to do so. They may get a beautiful picture for the time shot, but the thing about it is, are those products going to stand the test of time? Are they going to be good 6 months down the line? Are they going to capture all of your portfolio moves? Does it lock you into just remaining static on your portfolio because you have to go in and constantly update your Excel spreadsheet? No need to do that with Stock Rover. It does everything for you. There's AT&T. There's a 2.1% of my over portfolio. Here's a small splice. That's T-Mobile. You bet. That's a brand new position in the dividend portfolio. As these positions increase, so will the pie in Stock Rover. It will account for all of those changes and increases in distribution of funds. There's Comcast. Right. And then my larger holdings, Walt Disney Company, Facebook, and Google. Right. So fantastic. So with that, guys, I'm going to be rolling out some more tutorials on these. Let's check future income just for fun. Absolutely. This is really cool, man. This really allows you. So this right here is the summary up to December of 2022. It always forecasts 2 years in advance. But if I look at the portfolio, this basically takes each and every of the accounts, right, and gives me what the accounts are rendering individual per month. This is incredible. So this groups it together per month. And then down here, of course, it throws in a visual representation. Guys, I'd be hard-pressed to say that there's an Excel spreadsheet out there that can do this level of deep analytics for you. But this gives you the amount of renderings per portfolio, right? So you can see here the lion's share of the dividends are coming from mine. Then next, it's coming from the next Roth. Then next, it's coming from the taxable brokerage, and so on and so forth. And then if you go into the individual holdings level, boom, it's a click away. There it is. Where are these dividends being rendered per month, right? So you can see here in the month of February, next month, I can expect that AbbVie, Citigroup, Realty Income Corp, Procter & Gamble, and Charles Schwab are going to render a small dividend. February is a rather anemic month. That's kind of embarrassing, 150.24. But let's cruise down here. I think March is a beast. Yeah, March is a beast. Yeah, you bet. March is a four-figure month. Fantastic. We'll take that. But this actually gives the listing of all the holdings that actually pay the dividend. You guys see that? That's insane. So really wanted to showcase. We'll come back to the dashboard here. Very, very simple. Very, very Incredible. This is going to be conducive to those folks out there that choose, like myself, to have multiple accounts. I try not to spread myself all over the place, but Stock Rover allows you to spread out a little bit, yes, but then bring it all home to give you that visual representation, number one. Two, the deep analytics and access to proprietary research through the Stock Rover platform. So all the links are provided in the description below, guys. The Independent Investor Channel is affiliated with and a product user of Stock Rover. I don't push through products that I don't use on the channel. That's kind of a rule of thumb for me. And I expect that you guys will at least take an objective look on this. Take advantage of the 14-day trial. Get started. If you don't like it, opt out. You've lost nothing. But if you do end up opting for their service, the Independent Investor Channel can receive a small compensation for providing this content to you guys and really showing you, walking you through a tutorial of what Stock Rover has to offer. So with that, guys, we'll kick you back to YouTube and we'll conclude the video. All right, guys, so we've come out of Stock Rover. I roll these out to you guys to provide you some insight on how I use Stock Rover. If it's something of interest to you, I think if you're working with a beginning portfolio, it may not be the best time for you right now. But I've spoke with way too many people in the community who need something like this, and they're looking for that opportunity to combine all of their accounts into a one-stop shop. And the Brokerage Connect allows that to happen. That was the main feature that showcased in this video, right? If I had one account, maybe it wouldn't be so important, but I think there's a lot of people who seek out strategic opportunity using a number of different brokerages, or they have a multitude of accounts within the same broker. Stock Rover allows you to separate those out and look at it from a total comprehensive portfolio picture and extrapolate the data for your own dissemination and use. There's no better product on the market. And I think for the long-standing data and the ability of Stock Rover to manage the data that you input, it'll stand the test of time. 6 months down the line, a year, 5 years, 10 years down the line, Stock Rover could be one of those integral parts of your portfolio analysis thesis. Whereas Excel spreadsheets seem to be really, really good on the onset, 6 months down the line, you've got so many errors and you spend all your time just monkeying around and tinkering with the Excel spreadsheet. It's a futile effort and our time is worth way more than that, guys. Stock Rover allows you to dump the data on them, let them do the data crunching, and you can move on with your day and do more important things. Guys, if you appreciate the content coming through, the Independent Investor Channel, want to make sure and subscribe to the message. I want to share this information for anybody out there that's looking for a portfolio tracker. Stock Rover's the best in the business. They are number one. If you want the number one stock tracker portfolio analyzer, this is it. Anything less than Stock Rover is futile. Yeah, it's less than subpar, in my opinion. There's no better than Stock Rover out there. You want to share it. Leave your comments at the bottom. Leave your tutorials. If you're having some experience with Stock Rover, you enjoy the product, even if you don't like the product. We need to be open on this forum about the Stock Rover experience, what it means to self-directed investors, and the ability to extrapolate data on the fly, real-time data and analytics, and how we're using that data to empower our own financial futures. Guys, appreciate you sticking with me through the totality of this tutorial. Thank you so much again. Good luck in your investment future.